Hell of a day, huh? Science experiments falling from the sky.
Having George on that plane is a big mistake.
I think we'll be all right.
Well, maybe not. That was Dwayne The Rock Johnson in that scene, and yes, he's going to move in to try to save the day and the planet from genetically mutated animals. You're looking there at some of the scenes from his latest action film called Rampage. Eli is here, and I'm really hoping you're going to go a rampage for us over this one today, because we love it when you do. Okay, tell us more about the film, and good morning to you.
So let's go back, good morning, to the source material. One of my favorite arcade. Remember arcade games?
In the 80s, right? Another 80s reference.
1986 Rampage. And I love the concept. Basically, you are the monster. You are King Kong. You are the creature. And your job is to climb up buildings and smash windows and eat soldiers. There you go. We brought you some great, right? What could be better? You climb up and down, try and avoid the tanks, smash the people, eat them for lunch. Wonderful. So here's what happens. 2009, Warner Brothers pays $33 million for Midway Games, buying the rights to Rampage and all the other arcade titles, which means, of course, now in 2018, it's time for Hollywood to remake it, where Dwayne is now Davis Okoye, not the gorilla, but a supersized Dr. Doolittle who watches his friendly gorilla pal George mutate and join a trio of beasts trying to smash Chicago. Let's take a look.
Are you familiar with genetic editing? Changes will be incredibly unpredictable. Increased strength.
George!
Speed, agility.
No!
Bad gorilla. So there you go. George has been exposed to some magic DNA splicing gas, and The Rock and Naomi Harris have to try and save George before he, you know, reduces Chicago to rubble.
To rubble. So The Rock.
The Rock.
I mean, he is omnipresent and omnipotent, it seems. Oh, he's all my omnis. He's everywhere, yeah. And he has the Midas touch with his films of late. He really is. Is he rolling on with this?
I mean, I'm sure the box office will do what the box office does.
Yes.
I wanted more from this.
Oh.
And I'm a Rock, I'm in Rock's corner. I call him The Rock because Dwayne doesn't really seem to encompass the mountain
man.
Of a man that he is. You know, I follow The Rock on Instagram, and he is hilarious and captivating and charismatic and kind of funny, and he's got this great energy. He's got a personality. It comes through those little Instagram posts. And I remember interviewing him a couple of years ago, and he can act. I mean, go back to 1995's Be Cool, where he was hilarious. And so when I interviewed him, I said, you know, why don't you slim down? Why stop trying to be the big man? Show Hollywood your acting chops. And he said to us, you know, I'm going to make a company to put myself forward instead of changing to fit Hollywood. Now, credit to The Rock, that is exactly what he's done. By box office or triceps, he is one of the biggest stars in the business. But whatever he is on Instagram, in this muddle of a movie, loses something in translation to the big screen. On Rampage, The Rock is just a big, bland boulder. Where's the charisma? Where's the playfulness? Where's the edge? Give me the sexy Rock, the silly Rock, an edgy Rock. Instead, what we get is a hollow He-Man, a movie star trying to conquer the globe by playing it safe. I mean, you think of Arnold, the classic Hollywood hero. I mean, yeah, he had the accent, but he had one-liners. Here, where Johnson sees a crocodile the size of a city block, his line, that sucks. Which brings me to the director, Gander's own Brad Peyton. Now, when the stuff is standing still, Peyton can make it look nice. But that scene there in the plane where George gets loose, it was a cinematic slurry. I had no idea what I was looking at. And the fact that the gorilla and Jeffrey Dean Morgan as this cowboy-flavored government agent actually steal the show mean that Dwayne Johnson needs to reconnect with whatever The Rock was cooking until they find a way to bring the guy from Instagram back to the big screen. I'm sticking with the video game, and this Rampage gets 2.5 stars out of 5.
But your Rampage gets 5 stars from me, as you always do. Thanks, Eli.
My pleasure.
See you next week.